MrExcel podcast brought to you by MrExcel. Excel in Depth, Chapter 14, Frequency Distribution. Well, hey, welcome back to the MrExcel netcast. I'm Bill Jelling. In Chapter 14, we talk about a lot of statistical functions. In particular, for the podcast, I chose the frequency function just because it is so hard to use. What frequency is used for when you want to group things into what scientists call bins. I'm going to use the more friendly term, a bucket. So what I have here is I have about 4,000 results. The results range from about 10 on up to 90. They're in one decimal place, so 49.5 kinds of things. And I want to find out how many of those results were less than 10, how many were from 10 to 19.99, and so on. And so to make this work, you have to build something called a bins array. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to build a bins array and say, hey, I want to see all the records that were 9.99 or less, and then everything from, well, essentially 10 up to 19.99. Let me drag that down here, and we'll go down to 89.9. All right, so that's my bins array. And notice that the bins array is always going to have one less item than what you want to return. All right, now to create the frequency function, here's what you have to do. You have to select several cells at once. Okay, so the cells adjacent to your bins array plus one extra cell. We're going to enter one formula in this entire range, so equal frequency. All right, say, okay, where's your data? My data's over here from A2 down to A4481, comma, and then where's the bins array? The bins array is to the left of my data. Let's include that. And you notice the bins array includes one less cell than the number of cells that we have selected. All right, now, because this is a formula that returns many results, and those results are going to be placed in several cells, we have to hold down Control and Shift and press Enter, and we now have the results here based on this bins array. So less than 9.99, zero records, but from 10 to 19.99, basically 10 to 20, you have 65 there. Okay, so it's a nice formula. It keeps updating. Now, if you just need to create this as a snapshot, I'm going to suggest you don't use the frequency array formula at all. You can just use a pivot table, insert, pivot table, click OK. Now, in our pivot table field list, we're going to take the result field and drag it down to row labels, and then take the result field and drag it to sum values. Now, over there in sum values, we're going to change the value field settings to show a count. And so, yeah, all right, great. It's saying that there were one record with 10, one record with 10.2, three records with 10.3, and so on. But what we want to do is we want to choose one of those value fields, come up here to group field, and say that we want to group this from 10 to 89.9 in 10 unit groups. Click OK, and there's our pivot table now showing that there were 65 records from 10 to 20, 171 from 20 to 30, and so on, matching the results we got there on the frequency. The frequency function still has a use, definitely, because it can automatically update as the numbers change or as we change the bins. But if you're just trying to get just a quick snapshot of the frequency, you can use the pivot table instead. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from MrExcel.